Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm going to show you how to make an apple fritter loaf today. Here's a list of ingredients. For this recipe, you will need brown sugar, cinnamon, butter, granulated sugar, eggs, vanilla extract, all-purpose flour, baking powder, milk, 3 apples, walnuts is optional, I'm putting walnuts in this, and icing sugar and milk or cream. So what you want to do is peel the skin off your apples, slice them into strips, and cube them. So in a separate bowl, take your cinnamon and brown sugar and mix it together. Next, you want to put in your butter and granulated sugar in your electric mixing bowl and whisk it together until creamed. I change that whisk to one with a spatula on it so I can get a better consistency. Much better. Okay, now grab 2 eggs, crack them in a bowl, then get your vanilla, place that into a bowl, and you want to start incorporating that into your wet mixture. Now you want to prepare your dry ingredients. This is flour and baking powder, and I'm adding this holiday spice blend that I received from a hotel dinner. And you want to whisk the 3 together until it's evenly incorporated. Now that looks like the right texture, so you want to go ahead and add in the dry ingredients. So that batter looks like it's ready for the milk. So I went ahead and slowly added it to my mixture and let it have a stir. And now you want to get your walnuts ready. Remember, it's optional, and your apples. And you add both to the batter mixture. I like the way that looks. So now it's time to get a loaf pan, and I'm going to line it with tin foil and grease the tin foil, or you can use without tin foil and just grease the pan. I added my cinnamon sugar to my apples, and here I am placing the apple fritter mixture to the loaf pan. Spread the batter in the bottom of the pan, and then you want to sprinkle your apple cinnamon sugar bits on top, like a first layer. And then here I shredded some butter on top, and that is also optional. You do not have to do that. And then apply your second layer of batter. Then top the loaf with the remaining apple bits and just incorporate and spread it and mix it all in on the top. And I went ahead and sprinkled some more walnuts because I love the texture. So now it's time to pop that loaf into a 350-degree oven and set a timer for 1 hour. Here I am checking up on my loaf in the oven, looking great. 5 minutes remaining. Now we gotta check for doneness. I'm using a knife, you can use a toothpick, but I want my knife to come out semi-clean, just like that, so it's ready to come out of the oven. So after you take it out of the oven, you want it to cool down, and you want to prepare your country glaze mixture. So let's go ahead and add some icing sugar to your electric mixer. And I'm using whipping cream, and go ahead and add 1 to 3 tablespoons in. And I want to make it very runny. because what I'm gonna do is poke holes in my loaf and allow the glaze to soak in like a sponge. On adding that glaze, and while that loaf is soaking in all that glaze, I'm gonna go ahead and make another batch of glaze. I'm gonna make it thicker to ice the top of that loaf, and there it is. Now let's get it ready for a plate and ready to serve. My recipe for an apple fritter loaf. I hope you guys enjoy it. Give it a try. Please like and subscribe, and please comment. Let me know how you liked it. And again, thank you guys for watching. Bye guys.